Hi, first graders. It's time to read Dino Writers, How to Train a Triceratops. And if you recall or remember, Josh is trying to tame this Triceratops charge. And actually, he found out that Amos tricked him into getting that wild Triceratops. He told the man who sold it to him that he could get Josh to buy it from him, even though he wasn't a very good dinosaur. He wasn't very tame or controlled. And so Josh says, he'd been tricked. The Triceratops was untamable. He turned to Sam and Abby, who had worry written all over their faces. What am I going to do now? So now he's not sure what to do with this Triceratops, and he wants to know how to tame a Triceratops, just like the name of the book, the title. Okay, hopefully we find out. Chapter 7. Josh sat up in bed and rubbed his eyes. He'd just been dreaming about riding through the roaring Jaws Valley when he was woken by a loud screeching noise outside. What the? It was pitch dark, the middle of the night, but he was sure he'd heard crunch. Pterodactyl, Josh cried. He'd know that sound anywhere. He raced to the window and looked out just in time to see one of the winged beasts swoop down low over the barn where some newly born iguanodons were being kept. It clattered against the roof, tearing at the wood with its claws. If that thing got in the barn, those baby guanos were done for. He leapt out of bed and jumped straight out of his window, racing for Plotter's pen. Nothing and no one was going to snatch up one of his family's iguanodons. There was no time to lose. The old Gallimimus roared with surprise as Josh jumped on his back. Then they raced out into the open across the barn. Get away from there, Josh cried, waving his arms above his head and readying him his lasso. The pterodactyl swooped down low and stretched its claws in his direction. In an instant, Plotter reared up in the fright, throwing Josh off his back. Josh hit the ground hard, knocking the wind from him. He could just make out the terrified cries of Plotter as he ran back to his pen. Plod, he said and groaned. Come back! But it was no use. As he looked up into the sky, his eyes went wide with fear. The pterodactyl was plunging from the sky toward him. Its claws sliced through the air like knife blades, and Josh had nowhere to run. He braced himself for impact. Suddenly, a roar went up from his side, and a huge shadow passed over him. Three pointed horns stabbed upward at the pterodactyl. Charge! Josh gasped. The huge triceratops roared angrily as he swiped and slashed at the sky, forcing the winged dinosaur to flap higher into the air. Josh jumped up, keeping a close eye on the dactyl. He felt something brush against his legs and looked down to see a large horn rising up from the ground towards him. Josh yelped in fright as he tumbled backward and then landed heavily on a pair of muscled shoulders. Beneath him, Charge snorted, as if telling Josh to hold on. Josh grabbed the young dino's horns just as it kicked into top gear. The ground rolled by in a blur as Charge raced after the fleeing pterodactyl, with Plotter charging back in the other direction toward the ranch. I guess you don't like dactyls much, Josh said and laughed, barely able to believe it. He'd hoped if he'd found something Charge liked, the Triceratops would let Josh ride him. He hadn't thought about trying to find something he didn't like. Up in the air, the dactyl took one look at the charging Triceratops and flapped faster. To Josh's amazement, Charge lowered his head and quickly began to close the gap. Faster than a bullet in a hurricane, Josh cheered. Panicked, the dactyl turned and tried to swipe at them with his claws, but Charge reared up onto his hind legs, stabbing at the sky with his horns. Josh whooped excitedly and held on tight. The pterodactyl gave an angry squawk, then flew straight up into the clouds. "You did it!" Josh called. But as the flying dino took to the skies, Charge didn't stop charging. Now that he was all excited, he was zooming around like a dinosaur possessed, just as Mr. Sanders came running down from the house. "Uh-oh," Josh said, but it was no use. Charge was heading right for the barn. Luckily, Josh knew exactly what to do. In an instant, he jumped up to stand on Charge's back, just like he'd done with Plotter. This time, though, he took his lasso, looped it around Charge's huge central horn. With a yank of the rope, he shifted the dinosaur's head to the left. Just as he was about to crash into the side of the barn, the charging dino gave a roar and came to a shuddering stop. His dad looked one-eyed, face to face, with the heaving, eager dino. "Dad! Charge saved the guanos!" Josh cheered. "And look, I got him under control, too." Charge gave an important snort. Well, kinda. Mr. Sanders watched Josh, open-mouthed. Eventually, though, he gave him a weary smile. "Well, son, in all the years of dino wrangling, I've never seen anyone ride a trihorn like that. I guess you got yourself the new dino you were after," he said. Does that mean I get to race him?" Josh asked. "I suppose it does," his dad began, "but on one condition."
"Anything," Josh said.
His dad cast an eye over what Josh was wearing. "No racing in your pajamas." The next morning, Josh couldn't wait to get going. The events of the night before were still fresh in his mind. He hadn't bought a dud dino after all. Amos had been wrong. Charge was crazy and willful, but he was as loyal as they came. And now he'd proved he could look after the guanos. His mom and dad had let him enter the race. As soon as he'd wolfed down breakfast, though, he went to check on Plotter in the Roundup barn. "You're a mighty fine dinosaur, Plod," he said, giving the old Gallimimus a pat on the neck. "But let's be honest, you ain't really built for racing." "Sorry I kept trying to make you get faster. From now on, buddy, you just go at whatever speed you feel is best." With a noisy slurp, Plotter licked Josh's face. "Ew, thanks for that, pal," Josh said with a laugh. His old dinosaur seemed happy at the idea of going on his own pace for once. Now Josh could focus on getting Charge ready for the race. Even though he had Charge under control, the Triceratops could go crazy at any minute. Just like when Josh daydreamed in class, Charge could be easily distracted. Josh needed something to keep the dino focused and ready for action. And he had just the right idea. I wonder what he's going to do to keep Charge focused on the race. I bet we'll find out more tomorrow. Thanks for listening.